And you know what? Mother Nature hopefully will cooperate with us as we get through race day. I know the next couple of days look good, but there could be a few isolated showers on Sunday. We're going to talk more about that and let you know if we think they're going to soak the track down once we get into the next couple of days. But a live look outside at the beautiful W Hotel in Austin, downtown Austin, Texas, shows for us that we have some cloudy skies that have filtered in overhead. Just a couple of clouds have built in over the past couple of hours, but still numbers doing pretty well considering we started off so cool earlier on today. For the third day in a row, we saw many spots fall into the upper 30s, otherwise low 40s, but now the lower 60s are being found in the thermometers across Central Texas. 61 degrees officially downtown. Lakeway, you're at 59 right now. Llano, all the way up to 63, but as mentioned and as we just saw, a few of those low clouds beginning to blossom here as we head through the noon hour, and a couple more are moving in from west to east across the Lone Star State early today. So a couple of peaks of sunshine here and there, otherwise predominantly cloudy skies from here on out all the way through sunset tonight, but I think we'll be able to manage numbers that eventually will get into the upper 60s today, and that's just a few degrees below average for mid to late November around here, and light southeasterly winds will be coming in throughout the rest of the day. Now, future clouds and radar are going to get us through the next few afternoons. We start off at 6 p.m. tonight, right around dinner time. I think those clouds will continue to linger overhead, maybe a few breaks here and there overnight. Notice into tomorrow morning's commute, a couple of showers popped up, but I think they'll all stay south of our viewing area here as we get through the next 12 hours or so. I don't think they'll be able to push far enough north to affect anyone around here. That's some good news. And then getting into tomorrow afternoon, a couple of breaks, a couple of clouds. So we'll call it a mixture of clouds and sunshine on our Friday with highs again in the upper 60s. But then as we get into the weekend, it looks like we'll finally be able to push our way back to average numbers. That's right around 71 degrees for this time of year. We'll come close to that tomorrow and Saturday with highs in the upper 60s. But then on Sunday, that's when those lower 70s come back into play. But once we get into those 70s on Sunday, the chance for rain comes into play. Probably about a 10% shot that we could see a widely isolated shower. I don't think it'll be enough to ruin the race plans. It probably won't be enough to produce even a thunderstorm, so we won't have to worry much about thunder and lightning. Just a couple of light drops of rain that will come by from time to time. 67, though, for your daytime high today. A couple of peaks of sun in the otherwise cloudy skies, and much of the same tonight, too. And tomorrow morning, which is also some good news, won't be as cool as it was this morning. We'll watch morning lows come down to around 43 degrees in downtown Austin, and then through the rest of the afternoon, partly to mainly sunny skies and a high of 68. A mixture of clouds and sunshine on Saturday. No wet weather. 68 Fan Fest is going to be hopping downtown, I'm pretty sure, on Saturday afternoon. Should be pretty good weather for it, too. And on race day, a chance for an isolated shower, otherwise partly cloudy, and a high of 72 degrees. So a pretty good looking stretch as we get into this F1 weekend.